Dear student, good morning to all. I welcome you for the online class. In this class, we see about chapter 7, fraction, continuation. Okay. In the previous class, we see about how we will write fraction using diagram. Okay. But in this class, we see about a fraction represent a division numerals. Okay. So, for the division fact, you have to write the fraction and for the fraction, you have to write division part. Both things you have to see in this class. Okay. I hope you are all complete the previous day homework. Do your homework regularly. In this chapter, fraction, how to do the quick assessment sums in your book itself. No need to do it in your note. Okay. See the sum. First one, write a fraction for each divisional fact. Okay. So, in your question, division factors given. For that given division fact, you have to write the fraction. What's the formula for fraction? Fraction equal to numerator by denominator. Which one is numerator? The upper part is called numerator and the lower part is called denominator. Okay, see the first one. 1 divided by 4. This is division fact. For the division fact, you have to write the fraction. So, 1 divided by 4. This is very, very easy. For the symbol divided by, how to write the fraction bar. Okay, that one line is called fraction bar. So, first you have to write 1 bar 4. So, that is 1 by 4. So, simply first number you have to write in the numerator and the second one you have to write in the denominator. So, 1 by 4. You have to read this number in number as 1 by 4. So, see the second one. 1 divided by 7. Whatever number. Suppose 5 divided by 9, 8 divided by 15. Whatever first number what is given, you have to write that first number in the numerator and second number in the denominator. In between, you have to write the fraction bar. 1 divided by 7. That is, you have to write it as 1 by 7. 1 that bar by 7. Okay. See the second one. So, first one is division factors given. You have to write the fraction. Second question, write a division fact for each fraction. So, fraction is given. From the fraction, you have to write the division fact. So, what is the first question? 9 by 13. 9 by 13. So, in this one, you have to remove that bar and you have to write divided by symbol. So, 9 divided by 13. 9 divided by 13. Then, this one, 3 by 7. So, first you have to write the first number. 3 divided by 7. So, 3 divided by 7. Okay, this is the method of writing division fact for the given fraction. Okay, I hope you are understand. Next one we see about self practice 7C. See the first one, circle the fractional group and fill in the box. So, diagram is given. From the diagram, you have to write the answer for the one. What is given in your question? 1 by 2 of 8. What is the meaning for 1 by 2 of 8? So, totally 8 pictures. That pencil like picture is given, no? Totally how many pictures are there? 8 pictures are there. So, for that, from that 8, you have to find the value of 1 by 2. Okay, 1 by 2 means. So, in numerator, what number is there? 1 and denominator 2. Of means multiply. Of means multiply. Okay. So, you have to multiply 1 by 2 of 8. You have to divide into what number in denominator? You have to divide that picture into that much of groups. Okay. In the denominator, what number is there? 2. So, you have to divide the picture into 2 groups. Equal. You have to divide equally. So, first you have to divide the picture into 2 parts. From that 2, what's the number in numerator? 1. So, from that part, 1 part is your share. That is the answer. 1 by 2 of 8. So, again I explain. Total number is given 8. Okay. From that 8, you have to divide. 1 by 2 means half. So, that is 1 part. That is your share. Okay. First, you have to divide what number in denominator. That much of group you have to divide. So, you have to divide this 8 into 2 groups. So, each group contains 4, 4. You have to circle. That one is 1 group. 1 circle contains 1 group. So, 1 by 2 of 8. So, in 1 group, how many pictures are there? 4. So, that is your answer. So, 1 by 2 of 8 is equal to 4. This is the method of writing using picture. But in the second sum, you directly using multiplication, you have to find the answer. Second one, find the answer. That is 3 by of 20. 3 by of 20. Of means multiply. So you have to write 3 by 4 into. You have to remove this of, and instead of, you have to write multiplication symbol. So you have to multiply this 3 by 4 with 20. So you have to divide that number and the denominator number. Okay, whole number in the denominator. So 4 in denominator, what number is there? 4. 4. So you have to divide this 20 by 4. Okay, so it's simply in both number you have to cancel in same table. So 1 4 is 4. How many 4s are 20? 5 4s are 20. So you have to remove it like 5, remove 20 and write 5. 5 4s are 20. How many times it will be present there? That much times you have to write in your answer. Okay, so 1 4 is 4, 5 4s are 20. You have to strike out and write 5. Now you have to multiply both these values, 3 and 5. So 3 into 5, 3 5s are 15. So your answer is 3 by 4 of 20 is 15. 3 by 4 of 20 is 15. What is the meaning for 3 by of 20? So totally, if you use picture mean, totally 20 pictures are there. Out of this 20 picture, you have to divide into 4 groups, 4 equal groups. In denominator 4 only there, no? Among these 4, 3 shares you have to take. In the first sum, you have to take 1 share, no? In the numerator 1 is there, so you have to take 1 share. In the numerator 3 is there, mean you have to take 3 shares, 3 parts. That is your answer. So 1 part contain 5, so totally 3 parts contain 15. Okay, this is the method of find the value of. Next, see the next one. Next, second one. Fine. Second sum, 2 by 3 of 18. So, you have to find the value of 2 by 3 of 18. 2 by 3, you have to remove of, and instead of, you have to write multiplication symbol. So 2 by 3 into 18. Now you have to cancel this whole number into by denominator. So in denominator what number is there? 3. So you have to say 3 double. 1 3 is 3. So you have to strike out this 3 and write 1. In how many times 3 in 18? 6 times. So 6 3s are 18. So you have to strike out 18 and write 6. Now in the numerator, 2 numbers are 2 into 6. In denominator, 1 only there. So no need to write 1 again. Simply have to multiply 2 and 6. So 2 into 6. 2 6 are 12. So 2 by 3 of 18 equal to 12. Next, see the self-fract is 70. In this one statement, the question is given like a method of statement. From that statement, you have to find the value. 1/4 of 12 apples in a basket or rotten. How many apples are rotten? So what is given? 1/4 of 12 apples. So totally 12 apples. You have to find 1/4. 1/4 means 1 by 4. So first you have to write it in a fraction form. So 1/4 means 1 by 4 of 12 apples. Of 12 equal to. So same method as previous sum. But the question is given in the statement. From the statement you have to write the fraction. So 1 by 4 of 12. So 1 by 4 into 12. 1 by 4 into 12. Now you have to strike out the denominator number and the number, total number. Okay, 1 4 is 4. Then how many 4s in 12? 3 4s. So strike out 12 and write 3. In the numerator, what are the two numbers? 1 and 3. So 1 into 3 equal to 3. Totally, thus 3 apples are rotten. Rotten means aliginath. Okay, so total apples rotten equal to 3. Okay, you understand? Next, see the second sum. Sharu had 9 balls. He lost 1/3 of them. How many balls did he lose? So totally Sharu had how many balls? 9 balls. He lost 1/3 of them. 1/3 of them are lost. How many balls did he lose? That you have to find the number of balls lost. So first you have to write the fraction. 1/3. 1/3 means 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 of totally how many balls? 9. So 1 by 3 of 9. Equal to, how will you write this one? 1 by 3 of means you have to multiply. So 1 by 3 into 9. Now you have to cancel the denominator and the whole number. 1 3 is 3 and the how many 3 is 3 3. So 3 3 is 9. Strike out and write 3. Now you have to multiply the numbers in the numerator. 1 into 3. So 1 into 3, 3. Thus 3 balls are lost. So totally how many moles are there? This is the method of doing statement sums. Next one also same method. Work out the value of each of the following. 1/4 of 12. So half means multiply. 1/4 into 12. So 1/4 of 12. 1/4 into 12. So now psych out the denominator and the number of whole numbers. Okay, 1 4 is 4, 3 4 is 12. So one, now you have to multiply the number in the numerator. 1 into 3, 3. So 1/4 of 12 equal to 3. Same method. Okay, 3/4 of 24. So how will you write? 3/4 into 24. Now we strike out. 1 4 is 4, 6 4 is 24. In the numerator, what are the numbers? 3 and 6. So 3 into 6. 3 6 are 18. So 3/4 of 12 equal to 18. Next, 6 to sum. How many hours are there in 1/3 of a day? So you have to find how many hours. So first you have to write 1 day equal to how many hours? 24 hours. So 1 day equal to 24 hours. 1/3 of a day is given in your question. So in for a day, how many days? 24. How many hours? 24 hours. So 1/3 of a day equal to 1/3 of 24. 1 day can 24 hours. So you have to write, instead of day you have to write 24. So 1/3 into 24. So now strike out 3 and 24. 1 3 is 3. 8 3 is 24. So 1 into 8. So 1/3 of a day equal to 8 hours. I hope you all understand this is the method of writing fraction from the given statement sums. Okay. Today home assignment. Do page number 119 and 21 quick assessment sums in your book itself, and self practice 70, third row number and fourth row number C to F, fifth and seventh sum. Thank you, children. Thank you all.